The third question on gyroscopic couple says that you have a uniform disc of 100 mm dia. This is the disc. Dia is 100 mm. Okay. So, phi is 100. And 5 kg mass is mounted midway between bearings 100 mm apart. So, these are the two bearings. And this disc is mounted on this shaft. Okay. And the bearings are 100 mm apart. Which keeps it in a horizontal plane. The disc spins about its axis at a constant speed of 1200 rpm. And it shows it is going in the anti-clockwise or the counterclockwise direction. Find the resultant reaction at each bearing due to the mass and the gyroscopic effects. Okay. So this is how the precessional motion is taking place. So this is the, you can say, initial axis of rotation, and this is the final axis of rotation. Okay, so this would be the active gyroscopic couple, and then you will have a reactive gyroscopic couple. Okay, so we are more interested in this reactive one, because if you look at this axis, okay, this couple would produce a downward force on the bearing B and an upward force on bearing A. So this couple will try to tilt the shaft like this. Okay. And due to the weight of this disc, you will have two reactions, RA and RB, at the two ends. Okay. Let's find out omega first of all, because for gyroscopic couple you need I, then you need omega, and then you need omega P. Okay. So I is how much? M into R square upon 2. M R square by 2. So you have 5. R is how much? 50 millimeters. You need meters. So you will write down 50 into 10 to the power minus 3 whole square. This is your moment of inertia. Okay, and you divide this by 2 and you get 0.00625 kg meter square. So this is the value of your moment of inertia. Now, for omega, you will use this RPM. So omega is 2 pi into 1200 upon 60. Okay, that would give you the value of omega as 125.66 radians per second. That is your omega. Alright. Now let's find out omega P. Omega P would be 2 pi into R. That's the one circumference. R is how much? 50 millimeters. Upon 60. That is your omega P. This would come out to be 5.236 radians per second. So we have omega and we have omega P and we have I. Put it in this equation, you get the value for C. So C would be 0.00625 into omega 125.66 into 5.236, and this would give you 4.112 Newton meter. So that is your gyroscopic couple. Okay, now we will find out these two values, RA and RB. Because this disc is mounted centrally, these two would be same, equal to half of the total weight of this disc. So RA is equal to RB, okay, is equal to mg by 2. So this is 5 into 9.81 upon 2. This gives you 24.525 newtons. So you have RA and you have RB. Okay. If now we find out this F and this F, then we will be able to find out the total reactions at these two bearings. Okay, now F is nothing but couple into this distance. Okay, or you can say couple into this entire distance. If I take couple about this point. Okay, so your F would be couple upon 0.1. That would be 4.112 by 0.1. That would be 41.12 newtons. So this is your F. On A, this F is positive, and on B, this F is negative, because that is in the downward direction due to this reactive gyroscopic couple. Now, the total reaction at A, this would be RA plus F. So 24.525 plus 41.12. You will have plus, this would give you 65.6, this would be 4.5 newtons. So this is the total reaction at bearing A. At bearing B, you will have RB minus F. So RB is how much? 24.525. Minus 41.12. That would leave us with a negative value of 16.515 newton. So this is a total negative reaction in the downwards direction, and this is a total positive reaction in the upwards direction. So this is how you solve a question like this on gyroscopic motion. After this, we'll move on to the next topic and talk about the gyroscopic motion, the gyroscopic couple which acts upon an aeroplane.